Right there, right there. There you go.
There you go. Go to your room. Go to your room. Go to your room. Go to your room.
We're back with the man of the hour,
the man of the year, the rabbit man himself,
Fred Baum, on today's G3 Sportsman, and we're going rabbit hunting.
Oh boy, that's a big fat rabbit.
I'm excited, Fred.
Oh, it's a good.
Get him.
I'm gonna tell you something right there.
Good girl. That is a good.
I gotta get him out of that.
That's a heck of a crappie right there.
Now get out of her way.
That's a good start right there.
Tell you what.
The G3 Sportsman is presented by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
Today on the G3 Sportsman, we're fixing to revisit a very dear friend of ours. In fact, one of the most popular shows we ever did has been with this man. Today we're right outside Mount Vernon, Missouri, here at the Talbert Conservation Area. We're gonna do a little rabbit hunt.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Now, you guys may recognize this handsome fella right here. This is Fred Baum. And I tell you, a nicer guy you'll never meet. And we're gonna do a little rabbit hunt today again, ain't we, Fred? I tell you, you know, we had so many responses after we did the show on Fred and his Baum Squad. So it's been about 3 years. Need to get back in here. Everybody's just wondering what in the heck you're doing, if you're still alive. You look younger than you ever were. And we're gonna go out with his dogs here. We're gonna get unloaded. We're gonna slip out here. We're gonna see if we can run a bunny or not. What do you think, Fred?
I've got something to hang on this dog lead.
Well, and they're ready to go, ain't they?
You bet they are.
Let's take a look at the Baum Squad.
G3 Sportsman and the Beagle Pack's back, the Baum Squad, and it's been a little while since we've had a TV show, but we're looking forward to finishing this one up. And I've got a lot of response from our last show, and I don't have as many hounds as I once had, but I'm down to a small pack, but I'm raising a few puppies now and building a brand new pack, so I'm back.
Well, we're at our first spot, didn't have to walk very far. It's probably about 3,000 or 4,000 acres in here. It seems pretty big, and it just looks like rabbits everywhere. So Fred's got them in here, and it shouldn't take them long. If there's a rabbit around, his dogs will find them. We're gonna ease around here, and the hunt has started. It's gonna be a lot of fun today, just following and watching Fred and listening to him and just how his dogs react to him. He's got some of the best dogs of anywhere, and he's real proud of them, and we're just tickled to be with him today, and let's go see if we can find that first rabbit. Well, as usual, didn't take long.
There he goes.
How about that? Already, first one in here, rabbit crossed the road right in front of us. Run right over here at this little old pond bank right here, so we know we've got a bunny.
We got a bunny.
The old Baum Squad's at it again, ain't they?
They got one on the string anyway.
I'll be dang. We'll give them a little bit of time, then just kind of catch up with it. Here, eventually, you'll see them. They'll just cross the trail.
They'll work right across there.
Yep, and they'll go right where he was. There's the old dog right there, isn't it?
Yeah, that's 4-year letterman right there.
Yeah, that's your...
All right, what?
That's a 4-year starter.
Yeah, that's starter. Now there's a true freshman coming out of the brush there.
Isn't that cool? Every one of them on the trail too.
On that trail, okay. Now
there we go.
There we go.
You want to head down that way, or you want to wait and let him come back? I guess there's two ways of doing it.
Two ways.
Follow the dogs. But we're old now, so we might all just stay.
You're not
old.
Yeah. Tell you what, let's. I think
They'll take it back?
Take it down by the pond, and I think they'll bring it back.
I think they'll bring him back.
Because this is home territory, and I think he'll be back. So, and if they don't bring him back, then we'll go to him.
This segment of the G3 Sportsman is brought to you by G3 Boats, a great catch. Fiocchi Ammunition, what's your game? Abu Garcia, for life. And by Garmin, we'll take you there.
Now what's going on now, Fred? Tell everybody what's...
Okay, right now the rabbit's starting to change directions down there, and so we'll wait and the dogs go just exactly where the rabbit goes, so we'll wait and see where the rabbit commits. He'll commit to go across the road, or he'll commit to go to the pond, and what he wants to do, that's why we're standing here, what he wants to do is get back over here to his home territory.
Yeah. Another thing I know that a lot of people don't do, you got to really stay still, don't you?
You do, like right here.
Because they'll see you.
They see you moving, your legs moving.
And the dogs are kind of moving back this way, so
yeah.
we should be.
If they see us moving too much, they won't come across the road.
Uh-huh.
So we just stand still.
Well, they're on a hot track now.
They are, but it's the same rabbit, so. Did that thing? You might have cut back.
There he is.
Holy cow.
Oh, Pete.
He come up my britches leg.
Yeah, I know he did. My goodness, huh?
Eric says no.
Yeah.
Yeah, right there. Right there, there. That thing run right up my pants leg.
It ran over all of us.
Eric says I didn't get him, and I believe it. But now he's liable to come out again up here.
Oh, exactly.
Or behind us or wherever.
Yes.
Why don't I let you shoot, Fred?
This beagling is such a wonderful sport, and I've been doing it for 40-some years, and I can't get enough of it. People say, well, you're going to get tired of it. It's just a fad that you're going through when I was in my 20s. I guess it's still a fad, because it's been 40-some years I've been training and running these beagles. And the music of a pack of hounds, the sounds of the hound is like a hillbilly opera to me.
Well, we've run into some bird hunters, and they've been bringing their dogs back in from hunting. It's kind of disrupted our hunt on this one right here. And right now, they've kind of jumped on another one on down the road since the disturbance with all the dogs smelling and going and everything. So we're going to ease down here and get on our second rabbit and see what if we can do a little better job with it right now. So Fred's talking to the hunters, and as soon as he gets caught up, we'll get on down the road. Well, he's run out of the thicket.
Yeah.
He's run out of the thicket now. We've seen him twice, and he's run out this way, and the dogs are just up there a little way, so we know that he's probably going to come back this way, ain't he, Fred? So
that's a plan. That's
we've actually got a little open territory right here.
Yeah,
so
if we hold real still when he pops out to see us, we just don't move, he'll move in a little closer in the gun range.
And there, he ain't come this way.
No, cut back in there.
Yeah, he hadn't come this way. But we had seen.
No.
That's not a very big pack, so they'll hit him again.
I know. I think we'll move up to him.
Just move up.
He went there twice.
Yeah, that's true. He did, didn't he?
So the third time be a charm. Good shot. Way to go, man. Oh, that white belly looks awful good. I will.
There we go. Little Fred Baum Squad rabbit here. We still got another one running too. There's rabbits all in here. But there's our first bunny. I'm one for two. Turn around here.
Oh, yeah.
Let's get this fancy new...
I love this coat.
Fancy new Beretta coat.
Oh, I love this.
We got to christen that thing.
Oh, man, can this be my Christmas present?
That's your Christmas present right there.
Oh, what a present, man.
Because you giving us this Christmas present, us getting to hunt with you.
Oh, listen, it's my treat to get hunting with you guys. What we're looking for is a hound with good straight legs, and that's so that you say, why you want straight legs? Well, we show them on the bench as well, but why we want them to have straight legs is people that run their dogs a lot. You want one with a wide dome head because there's room for more brains in it. Hold your head down, to your girl. And also, if the ears touch the black on the nose, that's what you're looking for. All right. You want the back. You want the top line, like in cattle or anything else. You want a good straight top line. A lot of beaglers like a good white tail. You can see them in the brush really well. And it doesn't matter about the color. In fact, there's 6 to 11 colors, they say. And some of them are tricolor, some of them are mixed. And it's got a good wide chest, like she does have a good wide chest. Does that mean she has a good sized lung so she can run a long time? If any of you are looking to buy or purchase a dog for hunting or for a pet and to hunt as well, one of the best things to do is find your reputable breeder and talk with them and ask to see about their pedigree and what they're out of and what they're bred for. Some are bred for a lot of different things, but a good beagle is always, almost all of them have good personalities. But just go hunt with them and they'll, if they have good beagles, they'll want to show them to you. And if they don't have good beagles, they'll probably want to sell them to you in the pen.
Fun to watch them.
Oh,
it's fun to watch them. Yeah, we had to have some hair in that new jacket.
Oh, man, I kind of hate to get blood on it, but that's just what it's about.
Especially when you go wear it to church.
Oh, no, I'm going to wear this to church Sunday.
This segment of the G3 Sportsman is brought to you by Beretta. 500 years, one passion. Mossback fish racks, no matter how you stack them, we attract them. Berkeley, catch more fish. Shakespeare, quality fishing tackle since 1897. And by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
Now these little dogs can understand a few English words. Hey, you're not ready? Hey, listen to me. Hey, listen to me, kid. You want a treat? Go to your room. Go to your room. Go to your room. Go to your room. You want a treat? Here's your treat. 1, 2, 3. 4. You're good, kids. That's good.
You know, Fred, you just hunt public land most of the time anyway, don't you?
Yeah, I do. That's about all's left.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And there's always plenty of rabbits to run.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about really killing the rabbits or whatnot.
No, it's not.
You know, shoot a couple here and there to eat.
Exactly. And if you shoot a lot of them, then I love to train them. I'd love to see them run. And if you shoot very many, then
you won't have none.
You have none to go back tomorrow.
Yeah.
So no, we're not going to shoot very many.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Yeah, but there's, you know, anybody can come out and hunt and do this. There was a shot somewhere.
Yeah.
Somebody's out hunting.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know how big this place is. Probably 3,000 or 4,000 acres.
4,000, I think it is, somewhere around there.
And mm-hmm. public area. There's been a lot of people just already been hunting in here, but we ain't had a problem finding rabbits.
No, they're still there so far. We're fairly early in the season yet because it closed February the 15th. So, but get down in the latter January and February, you get some pretty thin, but you know, that happens everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we got them barking back here again. So
yeah, we do.
We better keep our eyes peeled, shouldn't we?
We better check on them.
Oh, yeah.
If you want to, we could stand on that corner and kind of hide because it came right around that corner. Yeah. And, let me just back up. It still could come across now.
Yeah.
They're close.
I gotta have my head on a swivel.
Ha ha ha.
I missed him again.
I miss him too. he's double
scared. I'll tell
now.
You what. A couple of sharpshooters like me and you, we're going to let them all go.
Missed him.
Wow.
Boy, now that's a fast rabbit, isn't it?
It's got to be. He's a supersonic rabbit. There's no way we could hit that rabbit.
No, it's got overdrive.
Yeah, there's no way we can hit that rabbit.
This is two different colors. This one here will have, it was a solid white when it was born, but this will turn, it turns out lemon, then it turns into red when they get grown. There's two little boys, that was, they're 3 weeks old, so they're just, they love for me to get them out. I only get them out 3 times a day, and I think they're getting used to me. I don't raise beagles per se. I sell just enough beagles to buy some dog feed, and maybe at the end of the year, I try to break even. That's what kind of business it is. But I have more than break even, having the joy of getting to run these dogs about 5 days a week. So I really appreciate all you folks that's called and written and send me things, and can't believe how nice people are and how they love these beagle hounds. So.
Cornfield bunnies, there he goes, right there, right here, right here, right here.
Oh, good shot, impossible shot, you got
him. How about
him.
That? How about that? Oh. That rabbit about gave us the slip, Fred. Oh, he come out, you'll see where the dogs come. He was actually kind of making a circle and just started coming right back up.
Oh boy, well, I'm anxious to see the dogs following him up.
And, yeah.
I don't have a retriever, but once in a while, one of these will retrieve, so I'm anxious to see if they'll do that.
You can hear them coming now.
Yeah.
Followed that same trail. We better go over to that rabbit, don't you think?
We get closer, let's walk closer to it, yes. Yep.
They'll have to identify.
Yes.
Well, they'll go right to it. Well, he's laying right there. I'll let you get with them, Fred, and do what you do to let them identify it.
Yeah, I will.
See him right yonder?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right there, yeah. Come on, that's Dolly. Come on, Dolly, you find it. Hold up, you're close, come on.
They'll circle back.
Yeah, they will.
They got him now. Oh,
close.
Now they got it. Look at it.
Yeah. Bring it here. Bring it here, baby. Here, bring it here. Bring it to me. Bring it here, girl. Bring it here. Come on. Come on. Did you see her roll?
Yeah, she did. She kind of rolled it too.
She had it in her mouth.
Nice, it's, healthy rabbit right there.
Way to go, Dolly.
Nice, healthy rabbit.
I'm proud of you, girl. I remember Scott saying one day we'd hunted all day or most of the day and we're ready to go home, and I said, how much longer you want to hunt? Scott said, well, we've got enough rabbits for supper, and let's leave the rest for seed. And I said, now that's a real sportsman. And I really do believe that, because so many other people don't think like I do, or like Scott does.
I'll tell you what, what a good day, Fred.
Oh, yeah.
Has it not been a fun day?
Oh, beautiful day, beautiful temperature. And a beautiful retrieve. Well, what, 6 yard retrieving.
And the bomb squad.
Well,
got the good old bomb squad.
Well,
I'll tell you.
We're working on a new one here. You see.
You know, we need to protect our resources out here, and it's a good thing that they've got these conservation areas out here
where
people like you can bring people like me out to hunt.
You bet.
We're not out here to try to shoot every rabbit that we could possibly see. We some of them get away, whether we want them to or not.
That's right.
But it's a good thing that we do. It's a great sport, you know. And I tell you what, as far as I'm concerned, you're the face of rabbit hunting.
Well,
everybody that watches the G3 Sportsman,
well,
no doubt.
Thank you. Well, I always look forward to you guys coming out whenever you can. And this year we're a little short on beagle power, but this little dog here, she's a freshman, you know.
Yeah. Well, I tell you, we've had a big time out here, and there's nothing like a good rabbit hunt to hear the beagle's hound run, and I tell you, it's just music to an old dog lover's ears.
Oh,
and we really do thank you. We've all been wondering about what's happened to you in the last 3 years, but we want everybody to know that Fred Baum is alive
still running rabbits. Still going after those rabbits.
That's it. But that's all the time we got for this week's show. I wish we could just keep going. We've got another one running here in the background. We hadn't got time to chase him, but we'll be out there doing something somewhere next week right here on the G3 Sportsman. Thanks for watching. You want to go get this one?
Let's go get it.
Well, here. Let's put this fancy coat to work now. I shoot all the rabbits, and that's your deal. You have to carry them.
The G3 Sportsman has been brought to you by G3 Boats, a great catch. Beoki Ammunition, what's in your gun? Abu Garcia, for life. Food Saver, the number one vacuum sealer. Garmin, we'll take you there. Mossback Fish Racks. Berkeley, catch more fish. Sony, Beretta, 500 years, one passion. Shakespeare, and by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
There's another one. These aren't bad to eat either.
No, I've tried them.
When you get hungry. You had one last time.
I've eaten them.
And they say you got a gnat coming over me.
Good Lord. I bet I not brought enough shells.
Here, Dolly. Come on here, Dolly. Dolly, hey, come here, baby. Dolly, come here. Come on, Dolly. Hand it to me.
We're giving the shooters bad names.
Oh, we are.